Hey everybody, it's Alyssa. Welcome back to my channel. So as you can see from the title, we are getting a new pet. And like I said previously, this is not something that I was expecting, but I'm taking him in for a friend that has some unfortunate situations happen with like where she's living, and she has to get rid of her animals, which is really, really sad. And I feel really horrible for her because she has more animals than I do. So I can't imagine how she's feeling right now. And I've never owned a mouse before. So his name is Dale. He's a year old mouse. I am going to be his new owner and take care of him. So I've never owned a mouse before. Like I said, I have had hamsters and I do have rats, and they're kind of similar to those. I feel like they're kind of in the middle of both hamster and rat care together. Put their care together, I feel like that's what a mouse is. And since he's a male, he is by himself, so I'm only getting one of them. He's been by himself since she's had him. She's had him since he was a couple weeks old, and he's now a year old. So he's used to being held because she's a really, really great owner. But I'm going to show you the stuff that I bought for him to take him in. And the day this video is up should be the day that I'm actually going to get him. So my Patreon will be down below. I will have videos and pictures of him on my Patreon, because you probably won't see the video of me getting him until next week or 2 weeks from now. So if you want to see like videos from today, then make sure to check out my Patreon down below. I have a bunch of boxes full of stuff for him, and she's a great owner. She already has stuff with him, but I wanted to get bigger and better stuff just because y'all know how I am when it comes to my animal care. I'm kind of extra. So let me show you all the stuff that I bought for Dale. Okay, so here is all of the boxes full of things that I got for Dale. And yeah, it's a little extra. He already has a bunch of stuff with him. I'm not too sure what stuff he already has. I know he does have a like Tiny Tails home, which I personally don't believe is big enough for a mouse or any really animal, in my opinion. Not saying she's a bad owner at all, but I'm not going to keep him in it. And she is feeding him the right food and everything like that, so I don't know what she's going to include with him. He does have some stuff already, like a water bottle and all that. So this is just stuff that I don't know what he has, and just being extra about it. So I didn't really ask too many questions because she's going through a lot right now. I don't want to like stress her out. I just got the basics: how old he is, how long she's had him, what he eats, stuff like that. So I'm going to go through the first box right here. So this box is full of the bedding that I'm going to use. So there's actually not tons of pet mouse care on YouTube, and it surprises me actually, because like with guinea pigs and a bunch of other animals, there's actually tons and tons of care videos for those animals. But for mice, there's really not that many. A lot of the research I had to do was with like two or three YouTubers and Google and like and educational websites for pet mice. So all of the research that I have done has been as much as I possibly can, because there's not that much out there about pet mice for some reason. And I find that kind of weird. But most of the care guides, almost all the care guides found, were saying that you should mix aspen and paper bedding together. So that is what I'm going to be doing. So I got the Katie aspen bedding. I read that this one is the best for dust control. They shouldn't have pine or cedar bedding. They have to have aspen if you do like wood chips like this. I have not done wood bedding for any of my animals just because it's always scared me with the dust and stuff like that. But this seemed to be the brand and that everybody was recommending on their videos, so I decided to go ahead and go for it. We'll see how it is. And then I will be mixing it with this Carefresh bedding. This is not scented, it's just in the color white. I just got whatever Carefresh bedding was on Amazon. Amazon does like one day delivery, and I needed it that soon because I'm getting him literally tomorrow. So one day delivery, I got all of this stuff, which is absolutely crazy. So I'm going to be mixing the aspen with this white Carefresh. I'll probably have tons left over. So that is the bedding, aspen and Carefresh. Now let's go through this box up here. I also did go to PetSmart, or ordered stuff from PetSmart. I ordered his food just because they didn't have fast delivery on the food on Amazon. So like I said, I watched a lot of food guides and read a bunch of food guides for pet mice, and I got the food that everybody recommended and used for their mice. So I got the Tropical Carnival Gourmet food, and this is what she feeds him now. I'm not too sure if she mixes it with the blocks, but she did send a picture of this, so we'll have another bag full of this. This is a food and treat all-in-one for pet mouse and rats. Here it is. I'm going to take out like the big chunks of stuff just because I feel like that's not safe for a mouse, but all the little things I will be keeping in there. It's a blend of seeds, veggies, nuts, and fruits. And I also read that you should mix it with this VitaSmart parakeet food, actually. And apparently this parakeet food is not even actually safe for parakeets, but it is safe for mice. So I'm going to mix this with the other food and also rat blocks, which are in another box because I did get the rat blocks from Amazon. So we've got these two things. Then I got a space pod. I have one of these for my rats and they love it. They sleep in it literally all the time. I got the purple and green one, and basically you can hang it from the top of the cage or you could sit it down like this, and a lot of mice and rats for sure really love hiding and stuffing all of their stuff inside of these. So I got this one. I got the smaller size, and then I also got this set of wooden like bridges because it had one day shipping, had good reviews, and I figured it would be a nice little thing to use for decor and make little like bridges across things. Okay, so these two things up here are actually shower curtain liners, and these are for my guinea pig. Stay tuned. I will be doing a video where I'm actually going to be turning my guinea pig enclosure to a floor enclosure. So yeah, that's for that. All right, then we have this Amazon box right here, and we have some critical care in here. I just got this as an emergency for my guinea pigs, so that's irrelevant. Then I got this really cute animal carrier. So I wanted to get something that was perfect size for him to pick him up in. I think she's probably just gonna bring him in his cage, which is a like Tiny Tails home. So that's already kind of like a carrier to begin with. So I probably won't put him in it in the car. But just in case there's ever an emergency, I need to take him to the vet or anything like that, it's good to have a little carrier. This is definitely not big enough for rats or anything like that. This is definitely just big enough for hamsters or mice. So if you want to get this, I would not get it for anything other than a hamster or a mouse or gerbil or something like that, because this is very, very, very tiny. I don't know if you can just tell how absolutely tiny it is. It's so cute though. And it comes with a little water bottle that you can attach. So this is really good for car rides. If you need to go to the vet, if you're moving, if you need to take your animal with you somewhere, this is perfect for small animals. I think it's really cute and great quality, and it actually wasn't expensive at all. Then we have the rat blocks. So I tried giving this to my actual rats and they will not eat these. They're super picky. They'll only eat their oxbow blocks, but this is the Missouri rat and mouse diet. I'm going to be mixing this with those other two foods that I showed you and making a big mix full of them. But this should be the main source in their diet. The other things are just those like little extras. This should be the main source of food for them. So yeah, that's what I got. And then lastly, I got this big like wooden hideout thing. So I got the smallest size just because I didn't really need the biggest size. And I see a lot of people use these for hamsters, so hopefully it'll be okay for mice and they won't like ruin it and pee all over it. They might though. And basically it's just a little hideout where they can hide all of their things inside of here. And I got the smallest size because I feel like that would be fine for mice. I don't know how it would be for bigger Syrian hamsters. I know my old hamster that I had probably wouldn't fit in this very well. So you definitely have to get the larger size, but this is great for a small mouse and they can use it to stuff all of their food and make a little hideout. And on the top of it, you can stack stuff on the top of it up here, like food bowls and stuff like that. But I feel like this is a really great item to use. All right, so those are the little accessories and everything that I got. Now I'm going to show you the cage. I watched a lot of videos on what was recommended for pet mice, and a lot of the enclosures are really, really expensive. There were some that were like $180 and smaller than this one. This enclosure was $60. It's plenty of room for a single mouse. I wouldn't get this for multiple mice, like if you have females. So I recommend this just if you have one, which you should only have one if you have males, by the way. So this is the Preview, I don't know how to say the name, Preview Pet product. This is the small animal home, and if you measure it out, it is 617 square feet, which is plenty room for a single mouse. It has a little stand and a bridge and everything. I don't know if I'm going to keep that in there. I might, but it is plenty of floor space for a singular mouse. I got it in dark gray, and it is a wired cage. I do have a 40 gallon tank that I was using for my hermit crabs. Sadly, my hermit crabs did pass away. I did post about it on Instagram if you guys are interested in reading about it, but I do have a 40 gallon tank that I was going to use for the mouse, but I figured a caged enclosure would be safer when it comes to ammonia levels and stuff like that. So that's why I went for this instead. And yeah, I think it's gonna work really good. I may have to like kind of fix it a little bit for mice because I read a lot of reviews with people saying that their mice were escaping through the corners of it. So I probably will be attaching like chicken wire or something to the corners just to keep it safe so he cannot escape from it. We'll see. I'm not too sure what I'm going to do yet, but it is good size for hamsters as well. I personally wouldn't put a hamster inside of it because I feel like they need more running space, but a lot of people use it for their hamsters and it's only $60, which is pretty cheap. Yeah, that's everything I got for my new hamster that I am getting tomorrow. The day you're seeing it's actually today. I literally just set up the time with her, so I am so excited. The next video you'll see will be me setting up everything, the enclosure and everything like that, and probably me getting him and putting him in the home. That'll just be one big video together. So this series is just kind of like a little two-part series. Me unboxing, me hauling and showing you everything, and then me setting it up and getting him. So stay tuned for that. It'll probably come out next week, I'm assuming. Thank you guys so much for the support here on my pet channel. It has been growing like crazy. I appreciate you guys so much. If you love animals and you want to support me and my animals that I have here, then feel free to hit the subscribe button down below. It is free. Also, make sure to check out my social medias down below. I recently made a pet Instagram so I could show you guys pet updates and everything like that. And my other channels are also down below as well. I hope you guys enjoyed and I'll see you next time. Bye guys!